Hey YouTubers, Mike Boris with the Mike Boris channel. Thank you for watching. Today we are going to show you the step-by-step process on how to properly and safely replace your valve cover on your Chevy Colorado. Now, a video link is scrolling above. We already have a few portions of the top portion of the engine removed. If you need help removing the top air case, the air filter hose, and a few additional parts, check out that link and then come right back here and we'll continue the process. Let's go out to the truck and get started.
At the engine, and what we need to do first is remove this battery, cut all electrical power for safety purposes, and we need to gain access to screws down below. We are wearing our pink gloves. It is October. We are paying respect and awareness to the Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Negative terminal, remove that. Positive terminal, remove it from the terminal lead, and you have this rubber hose. Carefully shift this off, and on the left side and right side you have clips. And on the front portion, you will remove this carefully. Try not to break this plastic tip. And an additional one right there. At that point, you can pull this whole case up and off. Set that in a safe location, and the rear nut down there, if yours is the same as mine, a 13 millimeter. Let's go ahead and remove that. At this point, the 13 millimeter nut is removed, and I remove the entire nut and bracket mount that secures the battery. From here, let's go ahead and remove the entire battery. Battery is fully removed and we have two additional connection points. They are plastic, be careful. One there and one comes through that little hole right there. After removing those, we can basically pull the entire battery tray out. At this point, we have better access to a few screws. We ultimately will be removing this entire throttle body. And with that said, we gotta come down below. Don't freak out, we have to remove a tire. This is easy. And once you remove the tire, make sure you have a jack stand supporting the weight, not the actual jack. From here, we need to remove this rain guard or splash guard. And you'll see several of these little plastic tabs here. My best advice when removing these clips, this portion here is the cap. See a little indent or groove? Grab a flathead screwdriver, insert it into that groove, and pop the cap out. After you pull this cap out, you can pull this entire clip out without breaking it. At this point, all 12 of those plastic tabs have been removed, and I got lucky. I didn't break a single one of them. From here, let's go ahead and separate this portion from the rain guard all the way around, and this entire guard you can remove. Rain guard is fully removed, and here's what it looks like. We now have much better access to the bottom screws for that throttle body case. And this step might be the most annoying portion, but be patient. You have a 10 millimeter bolt up there, one behind this electrical wiring there, and you have an additional 10 millimeter bolt back there. Go ahead and shift that red connection point off its connection point. You can shift that electrical wiring to give you better access to that upper bolt under there. And an additional bolt right up under here, as you can see right there. And coming up top, you have one here and one there. Go ahead and remove those. Next, let's start taking apart the electrical connection points, and you have several. You just have to be patient, make your way around. And what I want to do is show you one quick little thing here. These little plastic tabs here basically shift right off, and that will come off with the valve cover. And the hose over here, connection point here, connection point here, connection point here. And these little things are pretty cool. They actually screw in, so by turning them to the left, you can basically take this one and that one off. Two additional connection points here, shift this little gray clip back, and you will see the little prong that you need to compress and shift out. That comes off. And the T25 bolt, go ahead and remove this, and this entire cap connection point will come off. One additional connection hose there. And a tip on where and how to access the 10 millimeter bolts to take this off. There are several openings on the throttle body case that you will insert a long extension ratchet and socket, again 10 millimeter, and we have all of them except for one loose. As you can see, it's pretty adjustable. However, there's one more 10 millimeter bolt underneath this alternator. Now, I want to stress a very important point. In the event that you bypass loosening this screw and you pry this to the side to gain access to one of the 10 millimeter bolts down here that look like that, guess what you're going to do? You are going to put too much stress on this 10 millimeter bolt down below, and in the event that you create a gap because of the stress by shifting this and pushing this to gain access to that bolt, here's what's going to happen. you are going to create a vacuum leak in your engine. And guess what? When that happens, your check engine light will go off for a vacuum leak, or it will send several other error codes and you won't be able to figure out what is the root cause of your issue. It's very possible that the codes will indicate that you need to change a few different parts on your engine, ultimately fixing them and still having this code because of the leak that we created down below. So we are going to take off the alternator or loosen it up to gain access to that 10 millimeter bolt. In front of the vehicle, come to the left side. We need to gain access to the actual tensioner. The cool thing about this, you can see a 15 millimeter bolt here. Don't pay any attention to that. Take your ratchet. There is a 3/8 square insert for just the ratchet tip. Once you insert it, you will turn it to the right and you will loosen up this actual belt and you can pull off the belt over here. So as you shift that ratchet to the right, have your other hand right here to pull the belt off. And I'm using an extender here, and basically I've got it positioned where I can just pull it off here. And this is a two-person job, or you will need both hands. Just like that, that's loose. Now that the belt is loose, we have three 15 millimeter bolts, one here, here, and one down below that you can access much better by coming up under here. Bolt number one is loose, they're long. Two more to go. Three bolts are removed from the alternator. We basically now can shift this down. And way back in there, go ahead and loosen up that 10 millimeter bolt. From here, we are going to come to the opposite side and four 10 millimeter bolts, two on top, two on the bottom. We are going to remove this throttle body and we now can basically shift this back slightly, gain access to the bolt. After removing the 10 millimeter bolts, very important, that green rubber gasket there. If you cannot ruin it during the removal process, good. If you cut that, scrape it, or ruin it, you have to purchase a new one. Set this in a safe location. Next step is to, again, go all around the entire valve cover and verify that you have all the electrical connection points loose. One additional one, this 10 millimeter bolt down here. You do not have to remove the upper one, just the lower one, because there is a new strap that comes on the new valve cover. A couple additional connection points here, and over here, go ahead and loosen up this because it's going to allow you to pull this entire wiring brace up. From here, undo all the 10 millimeter bolts around the entire radius of the cover. All 10 millimeter bolts, the entire radius of the cover, are now removed. And again, this is loose to a point where we really don't need to remove this. However, when you are shifting this back, and we are going to shift it out toward us, and leave this wire harness in place. There's a couple connection points again down there. And be very careful because you don't want to overstress this case. Okay, we have fully removed the valve cover. Just be very careful, be very patient as you remove it. And as you pull the valve cover outward, just slowly shift the electrical harness down and this entire case comes off. There's the inside of the engine. There's your camshaft, your valves, there's your timing chain, gears, etc. Bolt part is out, and remove the gaskets. You've got the gasket that goes around the entire radius, and then you've got these grommet oval shaped gaskets that actually go right there. And in our case, they all stuck on this portion of the engine. Just slowly and careful peel them off because the new valve cover comes with all new gaskets. New parts in the box, let's go ahead and open it. Here is the new part, and the gasket is already in place, and there are all the oval grommet shaped gaskets that go over your spark plug areas, and verify your valve cover has those. Next thing I want to point out, prior to inserting and securing the new valve cover, very important, clean the entire surface that the gasket is going to rest and seat itself to the engine. Even the internal portions here, we've taken a shop towel and cleaned the entire radius surface and all five of the surfaces and the inner portion. Back to the new valve covers, time to install it. And my recommendation, be very careful, be very patient. And as you insert this into the engine and position it on top of the engine, be very, very careful with this rubber gasket. Do not harm it as you insert it. Next step, I grabbed brand new oil. You don't need a lot. All you need to do, dab your finger, and you want to run this the entire radius of your gasket. And you may need to dip it a couple times in here. What you're ultimately doing is lubricating this rubber seal, and as you tighten all the 10 millimeter bolts, this rubber seal with the oil will seat itself to the engine much better than if this gasket was completely dry.
New valve cover is in, properly set. And again, before beginning to tighten all these screws, and I'll show you how to do it, you want to go in a pattern sequence. You'll tighten this one first, hot to the backside, tighten that one, not all the way tight, basically just hand tight, go over to the corner, then come over here, then move basically in a star pattern as you tighten these. And again, prior to tightening it, double check the gasket, the entire radius around, make sure that rubber gasket is not altered or out of place in the little groove on the cover. As far as the tightening process, if you do not have a torque wrench, you will tighten the 10 millimeter bolt until it is slightly caught, and then up here, grab it on the base and give it just one small turn there. Do not over tighten any of these bolts because they will snap and you do not want that. Next, resecure the oil cap, and from here, let's reverse the steps. We are going to resecure the electrical wiring. We are going to secure as many of the electrical connection points as we can and basically start moving all the way around the entire valve cover and resecuring everything. We'll resecure this harness. And as far as the old pieces or connection tabs on the old cover, make the radius around and grab all the old connection points. We started in the back right corner, secure this hose, electrical connection point there, and an additional one back here. These are your 5 electrical connection points for your coils. This will go on your throttle body. Got connection point here, and this harness connection, and the clamps all down here, electrical connection point here, an additional one way down there. And from here, we are going to spend a few minutes and resecure all the 10 millimeter bolts for the case. After that, we are going to resecure the alternator and serpentine valve. At this point, the intake manifold is fully secured. Those 2 10 millimeter bolts right there secure. You've got 2 way down in the far corner down there. You've got 2 closest to the alternator. And coming back down below, again, you have several additional bolts up in there, as you can see. Just make sure all of those are secure. And remember earlier we took off that red clip, re-secure that clip and that bolt in the event that you took off that. And again, all up under there, just verify all of those 10 millimeter bolts are secure. Back up top, we are now going to re-secure the alternator. Alternator re-secured, 2 bolts on top, 1 on the bottom. The serpentine belt is re-secured. It's probably a good idea in the beginning of the project to take a photo of the serpentine belt so you know how it loops around the pulleys and back on when it comes time to reinsert it. From here, moving to the top, we'll go ahead and insert the throttle body and secure that. Throttle body is re-secured, 10 millimeter bolts, 2 on the top, 2 on the bottom. The hose there, the electrical connection point there, that little connection point, and that T-bolt, secure that to secure that electrical connection point. From here, let's go ahead and insert the 5 ignition coils and secure those. I want to point out, put anti-seize lubricant on all of these ignition coil bolts. This is just preventative maintenance. You will replace these coils, and so when we put them back on, they're going to be much easier to take off when it comes time to replace them. Ignition coils are back on, and I even got this little case back on. And from here, let's go ahead and reconnect the throttle body hose and top case there, as well as the air filter hose. Top hose is connected, and again, on that back side, you have that little connection point. There is a hose on the bottom side of that case. We need to secure that as we position the top case into place. Top case properly positioned and secured. You've got 2 clamps here, flathead screw there, 1 on the back side there, and you've got the flathead screwdriver clamp there, as well as the one up top here. The top portion is all secure. Now let's reinsert the battery and secure the battery. Battery is repositioned and installed and connected to the terminals, negative and positive. The rubber hose is connected, as well as the connection points there and on the back side. From here, come down and realign your rain guard or splash guard and resecure it with all 12 of those plastic tabs. After the splash guard is resecured, go ahead and grab the tire and secure the tire. From there, we will jack the truck back up, remove the jack stand, and get rid of the jack. Tire's back on and secure, and we are going to start the engine. All right, very cool. We are going to let this engine run for about 15 minutes, let it warm up, and then we're going to shut the engine off and check for any leaks on the entire radius of the valve cover gasket.
Okay, YouTubers, we let the engine run for about 20 minutes and we took a flashlight and checked the entire radius of the valve cover and no leaks. Successful job.
That's it, YouTubers. As you can see, a pretty quick, friendly DIY project. It just requires your patience. And do us a favor, below the video, you will see that thumbs up icon. Click on that, like the video, subscribe to the channel. Definitely go to your settings, turn on your YouTube notification bell. Once you do that, every video that we upload, you will be notified. You will be able to stay up to date with us, and that will be awesome. Thanks again for watching.